Hey folks, Happy New Year from all of us here at Road Trip. Well, it's been 2 years, 2 months we haven't talked to you. Well, the last time we talked to you was during Christmas celebration, during the tree light and everything else, and we're glad you enjoyed it. And I hope you enjoy as much as New Year's as we celebrate 2024 with all new episodes, the first time in 2 years or 2 months. Now that I'm happy to be returning, we got some great all-new shows, and we finally deserved it as well. And I'll tell you about that in just a minute. And when you see this new opening, by the way, the same opening it is to Road Trip, take a look at the new graphic. This is so cool. Even if it wasn't a different location. Today, on this show, we got Able on Air. And it's a show hosted by Lawrence and Arline Sieler. And I was the guest on this episode. And it's going to be two parts. I'll tell you why later. But for right now, enjoy the brand new opening. The same music, the same opening stuff, but a different location in Philadelphia, the Blood Police, and then you see the new graphics. You'll see why in a minute. But for now, I'm Ron Rodden, and thank God this is 2024, because this is Road Trip. Holder, Happy New Year to all of you from everybody here at Road Trip. It's the first show 2024. I told you I like that great new graphic that you just saw just a moment ago. It's brand new for us, and I want to say thanks to the staff and the people who said, are you kidding me? It's just real easy. Anyway, it's good to be back. It's been 2 years and 2 months we haven't talked to you guys in a while after we did the Christmas show. Just the last couple weeks ago, and it was a lot of fun out there in Princeton. And I want to say quickly a shout out to the folks in Princeton, New Jersey at Palmer Square. That is what it's been fantastic about three, and we're going to be back again next year, so stay tuned. It's going to be so much fun anyway. And as we kick off in season 9, and this is only our first show, I want to say a lot of people who make a lot of shows about it and said, we haven't been back here for quite some time. It says, we're here. Of course, we have our new computer back up and running. We have a new camera on and running. And shout out to Audrey Blackwood Folder, who's my new production assistant, who always gets me right into the right way. So thank you, Audrey, wherever you are. We love you. Second thing I want to say to the staff and people of Brick, I tell you, it's really a great run so far. We are number 9. We're getting close to the big lucky number 10. And I don't think it's going to be easy to get to our 10th season and gain close to 300 shows. But you got to stay tuned all year long because this is going to be a lot of fun. And I also want to add to the staff, the people, Brick, we missed you guys. So good thing we're back for all new episodes. The sad part also, I always be back again this year, and I don't know how too much of everything it is our friends who've been passed away within the last year and a half, and I was so teared up and something about that. We missed a lot of people, like our production assistant. I said, when Arthur Blackwood had a husband, he is very nice, and we want to say thank you for your service and everything else, and that is right for there. That is Arthur Blackwood's husband, and we love him so much, missed to be exact anyway. The second thing also, I mentioned Mitchell Wiener, one of our guys. We always clown around with it since times when pre-Volk and back in CGS, and he was very funny, and he's a mail clerk, and we're going to be missed under his wife, who had her, that is Lisa Wiener. And also, I want to say, Irene Stanovitz Laziri, and she is also part of our family for quite some time, for my 33 plus years, which I know her so much. And you know, when you had her, say that you're more like a brother to me, and you take care of her, and you did everything what we were supposed to do. And I said, thank you for pulling me up all the way to this show, until this very moment. And that is what this is all about. That's the real thing, because I know there's a lot to be missed anyway. Okay, now, let's talk about today. Oh, before I do that, I want to tell everybody that this season on Road Trip, it's going to be a lot of crazy fun stuff, a lot of fun. We're going to have another set of Game Show Studios way back, thanks to Art Kurtz and Phil Manners and Xander Friedman. Send me some of the episodes, some of the crafts. The place was Manhattan Beach Jewish Center, and that's in Brooklyn, in Manhattan Beach area. And there's so much going crazy about game shows. Among the game shows you'll be checking out this year will be include game shows such as Mind Readers and Tattle Tales, and there is also Reach for the Stars. Plus, the Game Show Studios Wayback will feature, of course, a lot of fun with Fractured Phrases. Now, I played the game, and I did terrible back then, my first year playing Fractured Phrases, and I had no clue what this game is all about until that moment. So while I was watching the video and watching R. James, the real 64 NBC version, I said, are you kidding me? This is a crazy game? Well, if this seriously true, I could host a game show. So you never can tell. And speaking of game shows, I'll be hosting game shows very soon from the Brick Studios, including the classic 60s match game and You Don't Say from the 60s. I'll get to host that game show, so we'll keep your eye on that. And one other thing, of course, about it, we'll have some more open mic music from Kenny Kelman's in Brooklyn, New York, on 95th Bay Ridge. A shout out to them. And, of course, we got some surprises and everything. So, just like in the words of the late Sam Brooks, of 10-10 Wings, he always said in the words, just two words, stay tuned. I'm begging you then. Just stay tuned. Now, let's talk about today. On our first of our 2024 shows, we're going to talk about sports, and we're talking about Special Olympics. The show is called Able on Air. It's taped over in Montpelier, Vermont, for ORCA, that's Onion River Cable Access, hosted by Lawrence and Arline Sieler. And I'm going to give a shout out to Arline to say hi over in Vermont. She's in rehab, and we want to say please get well soon. I hope she walks again, and we're all praying for you, definitely. But she wasn't home, one part. I was home in another part. And Lawrence Sieler was in the studio. So we talk a lot of sports and a lot about Special Olympics. Well, coming up in a few minutes, when we come back from this break, we're going to show you the episode. And this is going to be a two-part show. So stay with us for that. But right now, we're going to have some business over there to take a look. And then we'll come back as we begin Able and On Air. And we'll see you after the break.
Macbeth, I am in blood. Stepped in so far that I should
all
wave.
All students, the blood drive is now open. Please report to the gymnasium.
Get your blood in the game. Donate blood today and save up to 3 lives in 1 hour.
Where do I sign up?
Sign up right here.
Okay.
Is this your first time?
Yeah.
Welcome to this edition of Able to On Air, the one and only program that focuses on the needs, concerns, and achievements of the differently able. I've always been your host, Lauren Sieler. And Arline Sieler's here. Say hi, Arline.
Hello.
Okay. On this edition, we will talk about sports and people with disabilities, and also sports and the COVID vaccine. With me to discuss sports is, or with us to discuss sports is Ron Rondon from Road Trip with Ron Rondon on Brooklyn Free Speech One TV. Ron, welcome to Able to On Air.
Thank you very much. It's good to see you again, and good to hear
Good. It's going wonderful. How's it going? I know sports has been really strange. Let's get into the interview here. I know sports has been really strange lately due to the pandemic. First of all, why don't we do this? Can you explain, for those that don't know, because I know you've been on the show before, and you help us out here at Ableton On Air talking about sports. Can you explain a little bit about your show and what your show is?
All right. Well, in New York? Now, I'm in the midway point of my 7th season road trip right now. This is a lot of fun during the hosting the show. It's going to be fantastic here. We're talking about pop culture, and the food, terrible events, a lot of surprises. Got some great music guests from the place that we also know as the Rehab Cafe, but right now they're still closed because of the pandemic. And then sometimes the Stardust Rainbow, it was just absolutely fantastic. We got great ones here. We'll hopefully be back open very soon, by the way, and it's going to be a lot of fun hosting. And by the way, the show is on every Friday night, like I usually say, 11:30 to midnight. But the early birds, we always get the new episodes, start from 4:30 a.m. to 5 a.m. It's in the same night, Friday morning, same day, Friday morning. So,
now, Brick Arts Media is the public access television station in Brooklyn, yes?
Yes, it is.
Can you explain a little bit about what they do?
Well, this is a terrific, we have about 610 hours of programming, a lot of programming from different shows, including my show, and of course, they also got Classified Ninja Theater, and there is, I can't remember a few other things. Lucy Jennifer Day, but she's no longer with us there. But there is a number of other shows. It's been so fantastic to serve our community down in Brooklyn and all across the Brooklyn area. And also you can check it out online as well on social media, on BrickArtMedia.org/1.
We're going to give that at the end of the show. So talk about a little bit more about, so what's going on in the world of sports? That's why we, main reason why we have you today.
There's a number of things I have to talk about. For example, we're happy that, for the last 9-10 months, we have no crowds in sports. And I'm just seeing, and you've seen before, the Mets baseball games and basketball games, they have cardboard cutouts of people right there. Mm-hmm. And that will donate to a lot of good charities, a lot of good organizations. That was just nice about it. And then sometimes we also saw on a basketball game, they have the one with the virtual screen that's being everything virtual, and there's a crowd and everything else. Well, I'm happy now that the crowd is going to be back inside the arenas and stadiums with a 10% capacity. And that's going to be just a perfect time to get it. But there is a catch. The whole thing, and you know about that now, Larry. You have to bring a signed piece of paper that you already took a COVID-19 shot, and it allows you into the building. And it's a nice thing.
From what I also understand, according to the Super Bowl, there was 22,000 fans.
Yeah.
In the arena for the Super Bowl, but I guess everybody had a negative shot.
Yeah.
So why don't we talk a little bit about the Super Bowl, the matchup.
Yeah, I'm also in shock, too, because I'm very pleased that we had crowds. Lucky we're bringing the crowd back to the stadium back then. But here's another nice thing about this. They brought 7,500 frontline workers who already had their shot during the COVID-19, and they came. And these are all heroes, by the way, and I want to thank them for what you've done across the country and here in back in Vermont and here in New York. They came from everywhere, 7,500 people, to see a great Super Bowl game, had a great outside performance, and you remember the weekend, did a great job on that. It was a lot of fun seeing this year. But I want to say, to my knowledge, congratulations to Tampa Bay, because I went with Kansas City. But there's something that I did not see this coming. And I want to say why.
Go ahead.
Okay. Tom Brady now the greatest of all time. He has 7 Super Bowl victories already. Nobody ever passes in like this. The second thing, Mr. Ennis, outstanding job coming out from Arizona to close to LA. He won a Super Bowl. But here's the big thing about this. Did not have it coming. If you remember last year in the Super Bowl, we had a first female head coach, first female assistant coach.
Yeah.
For San Francisco. Well, they lost. This year, we have seen history. We have history in the making. The assistant and strength sitting coach, Maral Javasir, is one. And the other one, Lori Luckett, are definitely the first two lady coaching staff members winning a Super Bowl. It's never happened before. I didn't see this coming. The other thing I didn't see, and I'm very happy too, we have a first ever female referee in a Super Bowl. Short. And that Super Bowl, by the way, is a lot of first, a lot of history.
And also, the NFL has made history lately as well. According to CNN, the NFL, as of January 24th, 2021, Robert Saleh, S-A-L-E-H. He is the first new head coach for the New York Jets, making history as the first Muslim American.
He's
the first Muslim American to lead the NFL.
Now you think that's great. See, this is what we think. This is a land of opportunity. I don't care what that no good Trump said about it. Glad he's gone. But I'm going to say, this has opened the door to everybody in the big picture. If it's the future of the NFL, if it's the future of the NBA. And if you remember one
because
time,
now it's giving people right now, right now. Now it's giving people more.
She is the first ever woman in-room head coach because of the problems that I forget his name. Popovich, who Levin represented, and then they had him took over as the first ever female coach and be an in-room head coach. This has never been happening like this before. Everything, like I said, is the first. We've seen history this year, even during this pandemic, it is definitely history. That's why I always like to say that.
Yeah.
Speaking about, and this is Black History Month too, speaking about sports. Is there anything going on with the, because I'm on their page, the New York Liberty?
Yeah.
Is there anything going on with the basketball with the New York Liberty, which happens to be a women's basketball team for the WNBA?
They will still be back next year. They'll still be back in May, so they have a good chance to get a better player. They're going to be a better way coach. If they need an assistant coaching staff, that can help a lot, and that's very important.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'll tell you, there's a lot to talk about sports and everything else, but there's more to come about this, and we're going to do that right after this break.
You're not going to get it all right. Just make sure you nail the big stuff, like making sure your kids are in the right seat for their age and size. Get it right at nhtsa.gov/the right seat.
As far as the New York Yankees, let's talk about baseball. I know we're jumping around, but this was a hard season for the New York Yankees. You want to talk about the New York Yankees?
Well,
and baseball in general. Baseball in general.
They can work something about their outstanding year as a Yankee team and a good franchise. I think this is going to be a good season because last year they won Berkeley. They almost clinched the East, but I think they deserve another chance to get the whole 162. But here's the one thing we're afraid of. This is about the pandemic, and I know we're still doing this anyway. But sometimes games could get postponed because of pandemic reasons. Sometimes they do. So hopefully we want to make it before games could. And sometimes, if I'm correct, sometimes before November or the 3rd November, that's my guess. But if I'm going to go take a gamble, I was going to say at the beginning of October, the first time we'll
get. What about baseball in general? What do you think about this whole the pandemic and not having fans in the stands, et cetera?
I know. With no fans in the stands, until the day with the World Series, if you remember back then in October, we have about 11,000 fans in this stadium. This has no fans because when you look at the stadium that with all these cardboard cutouts, it's like that. But if you remember when Fox Sports did something unusual, very creative, they used computer-generated crowd. If you see a computer-generated crowd with a fan, like, they look real, but they're computer-generated. And this is what the crowd looks like. And then seeing them, it's like a real thing. But that's not the point. But we like to see playing fans back as well. And same thing as soccer, and every soccer fan would have no fans either.
Yeah.
Since the Premier League and the Italian League Series A, and of course the German Bundesliga, something like that. So they have just without a crowd, and this is what we're all talking about. And we hope by the time of this pandemic, they want to bring fans. That's like 10% capacity. That's like we talked about, and you know we want to see the people who are diehard fans, and they have to do everything they have to do.
Since we're talking about...
How was hockey season this year?
Well, I'm happy so far. The Islanders are doing very well. And, of course, this is their final season at the Nassau Coliseum, by the way.
So what's going to happen after that? Where are they going to go?
They'll be heading to the UBS Arena near Belmont Park.
Oh, wow.
That's in Elmont, New York. And they're just about to build a brand new indoor stadium. And it's just amazing. I'll show you the picture once I send it to you, if you have anything to say about that.
Speaking
of the New York Stadium, it is right there at home. We have the New York Islanders playing in their home stadium. And it's going to start sometime in October 2021.
No, no.
Speaking about sports. Let's talk about, and we'll get back to hockey in a minute. Recently, back in January, Hank Aaron passed away.
He was one of the greatest players of all time because when you look back at great history, great milestones, and I remember the night, I was a kid back there when I was 8 years old, watching that Monday night game between, I think it's the San Diego Padres. Hank Aaron came up to the bat, and I've never seen a terrific year. He got 7 points, but when he got the 715th home run, that was a real miracle. We have seen history. Their fans were there. The fans were there. He hit it right to the left of the corner, and that is just
But
when you look back at all his history, and then looking at his congratulatory to Barry Bonds, who broke the record, this is what he says. He is definitely the past torch. What he says, the torch is now passed. You are now the greatest of all time. I think he still is the greatest of all time because Hank Aaron, one of the greatest players of all time, and he is a lot to be proud of.
I think also back in 2020, another baseball person that was it Yogi Berra or Phil Rizzuto? Who?
Yeah, you forgot about Tom Seaver.
Yogi Berra.
Oh, it was Yogi Berra who passed away.
Yeah.
Oh, nobody even told me Yogi Berra passed away.
Huh?
Nobody even told me Yogi Berra passed away.
Hold on, one second, I'll get it real quick.
All right, but I'm gonna tell you one other player just passed away. Was Tom Seaver, one of the greatest baseball pitchers of all time.
No. Yogi Berra didn't die. It was he died in 2015, but go ahead. What were you saying?
Tom Seaver, he did pass away sometime during the summer.
Yeah.
Because of COVID-19, and yeah. He was 74 years old. And we dedicated a lot of outside Tom Seaver Way, right outside City Field. And we put a lot of flowers, gifts, and everything else, and it was a lot to be proud that we've seen a great, great ball player, great pitcher, one of the greatest of all time.
Let's see. Oh, yeah, August 31st, Tom Seaver, November 17th, 1944 to August 31st, 2020.
Right.
He was nicknamed the franchise.
Yeah.
And he's an outstanding pitcher. I'll say one of the best pitchers ever, as a great, great pitcher. And I say he's Hall of Famer. He's Hall of Famer all the way. He went from New York, from Mets, to Cincinnati, the Chicago White Sox, ended up being a broadcaster for the last, I don't know how many years, about 5-6 years with the Mets, 11, and then he retired after all this.
Well, that is going to wrap up today's show, but the interview continues. We're going to carry over the rest of the interview next week as we talk Special Olympics and other stuff we're going to talk about from Lawrence and Arline Sieler. So you got to tune in next week for part two of our two-part interview with Able on Air's Lawrence and Arline Sieler. Now, keep in mind that please join us tomorrow. That's about 15 and a half hours from now for Xander Friedman's video game series. That's going to be 3:30 to 4 o'clock on Saturdays right here on Brooklyn Research 1. And then tune in to BFS3, and that's going to be so good, from 1 to 1:30 a.m. and then Sunday from 12:30 p.m. to 1 p.m. for Game Show Block Party hosted by Art Kurtz, Phil Manners, and yes, Xander Friedman. It's going to be on Brooklyn Precinct 3 and it'll get Tuesdays at 2 on Manhattan Neighborhood Network, Lifestyle Channel 2, and it's Cable Channel 56. All right, that's all for now. Thanks for joining us. We'll be back in about 167 hours, 21 minutes and 15 seconds from now. But coming up right after the break, for you folks in the mornings, we have another great show on the early morning side. And for us here at 11:30 to 12, you know who we were talking about. Sci-Fi Ninja Fear is next, hosted by Shadow Ninja. And I know why I said Shadow Ninja, because I don't know why he's Shadow Ninja. Well, watch it coming up next. In the meantime, we'll see you next week. I'm Ron Rodden, and for everybody who's a part of this show tonight, always keep the faith. So long, bye-bye, bye-bye. And what you're about to see now, for the first time ever, our new graphic production, including this man. Hit it, soldier.
Very interesting.
This is Don Wilson saying good night.